Hello, my name is Jolie De Backer, and in the next couple of minutes, I will talk to you about Marfan syndrome and how this disease is diagnosed. Marfan syndrome is a rare disorder of connective tissue affecting approximately 1 in 5 to 1 in 10,000 people. It is a multisystemic disease, meaning that it typically affects multiple organ systems. I will get back to this in a minute. Marfan syndrome is caused by genetic defects or pathogenic variants in a gene called fibrillin 1 gene. As I just mentioned, Marfan syndrome affects multiple organ systems, among which the cardiovascular organ system is very important, since cardiovascular complications will affect life expectancy of people with Marfan syndrome. The aortic root, which is the proximal part of our largest body vessel, originating at the aortic valve, will typically dilate at a much faster rate than in normal people. With increasing diameters, the risk for tears in the vessel wall called dissection increases. Aortic dissection is a very serious complication associated with high mortality and morbidity. Another typical cardiovascular manifestation of Marfan syndrome is mitral valve prolapse, where the valve between the left atrium and left ventricle is typically too thick and too mobile. Mitral valve prolapse may induce regurgitation of the valve and eventually lead to heart failure. The other cardinal organ system when it comes to diagnosing Marfan syndrome is the ocular system. Up to 60% of people with Marfan syndrome will present with luxation of the lens, again caused by weakness of tiny fibers in the eye that are supposed to keep the lenses in their place. Moderate to severe myopia or nearsightedness is another typical ocular manifestation of Marfan syndrome. Other organ systems involved in Marfan syndrome include the skeletal system, where long bone overgrowth and increased laxity of the ligaments will lead to typical facial characteristics with a long face and typical high palate, chest wall deformities in a form of pectum excavatum, a funnel chest, or carinatum, a pigeon breast, are also typical, as are abnormal curvatures of the spine in the form of scoliosis and or kyphosis. Limbs are typically very long in Marfan syndrome patients, leading to an increased arm span. Fingers and toes are elongated, leading to spider-like hands or arachnodactylia. Other manifestations include pneumothorax or striae or stretch marks on the skin, which are typically located at the shoulders or the lower back. In order to score these manifestations in different organ systems for diagnostic purposes, a so-called systemic score has been developed, assigning points to each manifestation, going from 3 points for arachnodactylia, 2 points for pectus carinatum, for hindfoot deformity, for radiological abnormalities of the hip bone called protrusio acetabuli, for pneumothorax, and for widening of the dural sac or dural ectasia. Finally, 1 point is assigned to the manifestations of mitral valve prolapse, an increased arm span, myopia, abnormal elbow extension, stretch marks, facial characteristics, and scoliosis and kyphosis. Pathogenic variants in the fibrillin 1 gene located on chromosome 15 have been identified as the underlying cause of Marfan syndrome more than 25 years ago. The fibrillin 1 gene encodes for the fibrillin 1 protein, which is an important component of connective tissue. Since the discovery of the gene, over 3,000 different variants have already been identified, spread throughout the gene, and nearly all patients or families harbor their own private mutation. Different types of mutation exist, the majority of which are being so-called missense variants, leading to the alteration of one amino acid for another. Other types include nonsense variants leading to the production of a shorter version of the protein. Interpretation of variants in the gene is not always easy, and in some cases results are not conclusive, which is also why genetic testing should not be considered as a diagnostic test in Marfan syndrome. Also important to acknowledge is that it is not possible to predict the severity of the disease manifestations based on the underlying gene defect. This is reflected by the wide spectrum of disease severity, even among members of the same family carrying the same mutation. The inheritance of Marfan syndrome is what we call autosomal dominant, meaning that typically an affected individual will have inherited the disease from one of his or her parents and has a 50% chance of transmitting the disease to each child. Men and women are affected equally. It should be noted that up to 1/4 of Marfan patients has a new or spontaneous mutation, meaning that it was not inherited from the parents. Based on the clinical manifestations that I mentioned, on the family history, and in some cases complemented with genetic information, rules for diagnosing Marfan syndrome have been established in the so-called revised Gent criteria, whereby in an isolated case the diagnosis will be confirmed when an individual presents with aortic root dilatation and ectopia lentis, or an individual has aortic root dilatation and a confirmed variant in the fibrillin 1 gene, or has aortic root dilatation with a systemic score above 7, or has ectopia lentis with a pathogenic variant in the fibrillin 1 gene known to be causing aortic dilatation. In the presence of a family history, rules are slightly different and slightly milder, where ectopia lentis and a family history of Marfan syndrome, or a systemic score above 7 points and a family history of Marfan syndrome, or aortic root dilatation and a family history of Marfan syndrome, are enough to establish the diagnosis. The key message that I wanted to bring with this presentation are firstly, and importantly, that the diagnosis of Marfan syndrome relies heavily on clinical manifestations, indicating the necessity of thorough examination in a multidisciplinary setting. Second, fibrillin 1 mutations are identified in a majority of Marfan people who fulfill the diagnostic criteria for the disease. And lastly, further improvement of diagnostic and management strategies will require collaborative efforts, of which the ERN is an important initiative.